Namaste everyone, I am Sahil Durati. So you are watching my YouTube channel, Mirsa Yoga. So today you will learn how to practice Bakasana. It's also known as the crow pose. So let's start. Okay, so the main thing is, for the crow pose you need to learn the alignment, because I am teaching from last 10 years. I observed my many students and the person, those who practice crow posture. So what are the mistakes? First we will talk about that. That they never see how they are placing their legs. So sometimes they just stand like this, sometimes they take more gap between their legs, sometimes they take less gap. So it also matters, guys. So be careful whenever you stand, your leg should be wide apart. It should be the outer borderline of your leg. Now from here you need to bend forward. Observe me. Bend your legs. So activate your hips. Guys, remember, your hips, your glutes is play a really important role in your Bakasana. So make sure your hips should be active. So it's like a squat. Okay, I'm taking the squatting position. So observe, my toes are not lifting up, it's just my toes and knees are in one straight line. Now observe. Now you need to bend your arms and the elbows. Observe my arm position. My shoulder, elbow, arm is in one straight line. So you need to bring your upper body down. Remember, upper body down. Okay, so your knees should come here under your armpits, completely set here. Observe, my elbow is coming in front of the shin bone. So this is the position of the Bakasana. Fingers are open and do not place your palms like this, right? Do not make the hole here. Okay, so it should be down completely, flat palm. So this finger will support you and it will save you while you will feel this bell. Okay, so you need to place your palm here. Now observe, after this I am not placing my palm now. Now I am going to shift my body weight and placing my palm. Now guys, observe the distance of between my arms and my leg. So some of us, we try to lift the body here by placing the palm here and we find a difficulty. See, it's blocked now. So I can't go further. Now observe, I am taking this position, hips are active and keep pushing my hip and back, pressing my palm, lifting the heels up. And arms are bent, but elbows are not going out. Do not place your leg like this. It should be on your tricep. Arms should be active completely. And then you can shift your body weight and you can balance here very easily. Right. So those who are beginners, how they can start this? Because in the beginning might be, it will be difficult for you to balance in Bakasana. So we will practice first with the block. Now with the block we will also use the bolster to protect the face. So some of you have little bit fear inside, might be I will fall down or I can hurt myself. So how you can protect yourself? Now observe, I will practice with the same alignment, guys. So observe, legs are wide apart, toes and knees are aligned. Now you need to place the block between your heels. Remember, not between your legs, not far from your legs. It should be between your heels, okay? Near to your right leg, because I am right. Now see, I am taking the same position. Knees again close to the armpits, elbow front of the shin bone, arms, legs are in one straight line, pressing the palm, raising the heel, shifting the body weight. Now observe, after taking this position, do not disconnect your knee and your triceps, not this. Okay, so you keep your knees on your triceps all the time, look forward or you can look back for a while, press it up on the block and from here start shifting your body. If you want, in the beginning you can keep your board pose up on the block, but better to not place. See, it's loose, I can balance now very easily because I am taking the support of the block, so it's become very easy. And look forward and you can hold this very easily and you can come back. So suppose now the bolster is here, so I will also show you what happens if you fall down while practicing this. I'm going to take the position. So suppose if I fall down, okay, it's here to protect me. Okay, it's here to protect your face. So don't worry, your smile will be there after the practice is done. Now one more thing, guys, you can also practice the Bakasana by placing the block at front, because we need to understand how to shift the body weight. It's really important. If you practice single leg Bakasana or any other posture, even while practicing headset also, we just learn this, how to shift the body weight. Now observe, I'm taking the same position. Yes. Okay. Now place a palm, shifting my body weight, and I'm going to place my forehead here. See, check the position of my elbow on the ribs.
shifting, placing my forehead and the legs will come. And you will be here, try to keep your legs active, little bit up, and from here also you can try to look up. Okay? But better to in the beginning just learn how you can shift your body weight more and more forward.
Okay. So this was the Bakasana. For the more techniques, guys, you can contact me on my YouTube channel. You can write down me how to practice Bakasana. I have also several techniques that you can use to improve your Bakasana. Okay, guys? So see you soon. Namaste.